Now here's a little nice nifty little tip to enable that any case that you file in a court of law, especially a criminal case, because it has so many moving parts that it is always, you know, beneficial to heed to this particular advice. And I will give you this advice in the form of a little anecdote. A couple of days ago, a client came to me and said that a case was filed against him on the basis of some forged and fabricated documents. That case had been going on for a very long time. Nothing was done about it till the time the client came to me. I immediately drafted an application. I drafted a complaint to the concerned police station saying that these forged and fabricated documents were used to falsely implicate my client, and therefore you should investigate into the matter. Of course, the police would not do anything because Indian police is just like that. So we immediately proceed to move the court under section 156(3) of the Criminal Procedure Code, where we ask for a direction by the court of the magistrate to direct the police to register an FIR and investigate into the matter. Now, here are the practical challenges that come up when you go and do something like this. So I went and first filed this application, which in Rohini District Court in New Delhi. I asked them when my matter will be listed. They said the matter will be listed at 2 p.m. after one day, after a gap of one day. So I go the same day that the application was supposed to be listed before the court. I check the list of the cases for that particular day, the list of new cases that have come up before the court. That file was not there in the list. I go and check back. They say go to the office of the CMM, where the staff of the CMM will tell you, that is the Chief Metropolitan Magistrate, and the staff will tell you whether the file has been moved or not. I go to the staff tell me that they check the register and they say that indeed the file has moved to the concerned court. They give me the name of the court. I go to the court, and in the court, the in charge of the files, if the matter is not listed for that particular day, or even before anything which comes before the court is always done, is all the files are in possession of the office of the Ahlmad of the court, A-H-L-M-A-D. The Ahlmad of the court is the one who manages all the files of that particular concerned court. A person that you see standing right next to the judge and handing him the files in district courts, he's called a reader of the court. And in the High Court and the Supreme Court, these people are called the court masters. Now, coming back to the Ahlmad, I went to this particular court of this Metropolitan Magistrate, of this Chief Metropolitan Magistrate. I go to his court, I talk to the Ahlmad, and I ask him that, you know, there's this file. The Ahlmad say, we've not received any such file. I go back to the CMM office, I take a picture of the receiving part of that file, which acknowledged that this file has been received by the court of the ACMM. I go back there and I show it to them. And then they tell me that there was a new Ahlmad which was there, because of which some files had been misplaced. I get the file traced out. I have it put up before the judge. If I would not have done any of these things, I would have gone cluelessly before the court, waited for my turn, and I would have realized that my matter has not been listed at all. So I ensured that all of this happened so that the judge could direct the police to file their reply to my application under section 156(3). Now, my matter was listed for the coming on record of the reply of the police for today. But I went 2 days prior from today, I went 2 days back, I went again to that court and I asked the concerned Nayab court. So every police station which is attached to a Metropolitan Magistrate or a Judicial Magistrate's court, there are a bunch of police stations. So every police station assigns one police officer to that particular court, and that police officer is called the Nayab court, N-A-I-B. The Nayab officer, which is attached to that particular court, he is the one who ensures that there is a proper channel of communication between the court as well as the police, the concerned police station. Now I go to this Nayab court and I ask him, have you received this file? There was supposed to be a reply. Has it come on record, or has summons not even gone out from this particular court yet? The Nayab court says, I have got nothing of application by this particular name. I go back to the Ahlmad, I tell the Ahlmad, you have not given a copy of the application to the Naib court so that he could take it to the police station. The Ahmed draws it up, draws up the summons, finally sends it to the Naib court. The Naib court takes it further. After that, today when I show up, the concerned officer who was marked this particular application shows up in court and says that he needs more time to study the case and to be able to come to a conclusion as to whether they are ready to register an FIR in the matter or not. Today, the moment the investigating officer walks out of the court, I knew there would be another little difficulty which this investigating officer will face. And that's why I rushed out of court and I asked him, do you have a copy of the charge sheet which was filed by your own police station against my client? The investigating, this particular officer, this investigating officer says, no, I do not. In fact, I will have a lot of difficulty in even accessing that old charge sheet because the investigating officer who had filed that charge sheet has now been transferred and we are not sure whether we'll be able to track that file or not. Now, if I were to leave this person alone, I would have to spend several weeks before anything would be done in my matter, where I want justice to be done as quickly as possible. Instead, I offer to, and my offer is graciously accepted by this investigating officer, where I make get a photocopy of the charge sheet against my client and I hand it over to him. And I show the investigating officer that these are the particular documents which have been forged and fabricated, which the earlier investigating officer himself said that these documents are forged and did not say that these are forged and fabricated, but said that we tried to ascertain the veracity of these documents and the people who had apparently, as alleged, issued these receipts, issued these documents, said that we have not issued any of these documents. So a clear case of forgery and fabrication is made out, and therefore you should not delay it any more further. You should go ahead and register that FIR and investigate into these offenses. The policeman was almost completely convinced. I do not know what's going to happen later. But all I can say for sure is that something which took me 10 minutes has now at the very least saved my client several days worth of wait before which the police could have done something. The valuable lesson over here is that as a litigator, you must realize and empathize with the court staff and with the investigating officers to whatever little extent you can, and understand that the practical aspect of things is that these people will mess up on every step of the way. And that is why you need to be diligent and you need to ensure standing on their head every single day in and out that they are doing their job. You will never get any thanks for that. It's a thankless job. They will never express their gratitude, but it is your client, the one who needs justice, and the only agent that can deliver that justice is you. You need to be extremely diligent about pursuing every single lead possible. That is what sets you apart from all the mediocre lawyers out there who struggle to make ends meet.